Hi, everyone. Welcome back to the Lawrence at Home. My name is Teacher Vivian, and today I'm going to be reading a story time to you about someone named Rosalind Franklin. But before we get started, I wanted to remind you to please like and subscribe to the Lawrence at Home so you can get updates on when we do cool science stuff or other story times too. So let's get started with this really awesome story. All right. Like I said, today we're going to be reading a story about Rosalind Franklin, who is an amazing scientist with an amazing discovery. And she's actually a huge inspiration to me. And we're going to learn about what she found out in her life today. Rosalind Franklin was born in England in 1920. When she was only 15 years old, she wanted to be a scientist. Wow, that is really awesome. Even at a young age, we can also have a heart for science too. We can be interested and ask lots of questions and have big dreams like that. When she went to college, she studied chemistry. Chemistry is when we study the things that make up the world, matter. And we can also study the substances and how they combine and change. I studied chemistry before in high school and even in middle school and here in college too. We get to mix lots of substances together like this chemist is doing right here. And sometimes they do some really cool things like they change colors or they make bubbles or they get hot or cold. Rosalind Franklin is most well known for a very cool discovery she made about something called DNA. I wonder what DNA stands for. It stands for something called deoxyribonucleic acid, but that's kind of a long word, so we'll just keep it to DNA today. Well, what is it? DNA is like the recipe book of the body. It gives our body instructions on what to do and what to make. So for example, if I want to make some cookies right here, I have to follow a recipe book. The recipe tells me to put chocolate chips, eggs, flour, sugar, and put it together to make cookies. And in the same way, this right here, which is DNA or a gene, it tells us the body what to do and what to make, like different kinds of proteins that we need. The DNA tells me what color my eyes are going to be, tells my body what color hair I'm going to have, and things like that too. Using x-rays to take pictures of DNA, Rosalind saw that it was shaped like something called a double helix, twisting and turning. Let's take a moment to look over here on the right here, at these pictures of the double helix. I think it kind of looks like something maybe like a ladder or a monkey bar. What do you think it kind of looks like? I think it might even look like a monkey bar or a ladder that's been twisted, like this. And this is the stuff that's inside of your body and telling your body what to do and what to make. However, two men, James Watson and Francis Crick, saw her photo and used it in their research without telling her. They won an award and they didn't say that they took her work. And it was not until after she passed away that it was said that she took the picture of the DNA. I don't know how that makes you feel, but that makes me really sad. If I found out a really cool research or really cool discovery, I would want someone else to be able to work together and put my name on the paper too. But these two men didn't do that, and that seems pretty unfair. Though she didn't receive the awards in her lifetime, today we see her as an awesome woman in STEAM who made an amazing discovery. I mean, the fact that we know what DNA looks like, it tells us a lot about our bodies and how they work. And many awards were named after her, and even a college is named after her. Right here, Rosalind Franklin University. And there's that picture of the photograph that she took. The university is a school that teaches medicine and science. I think Rosalind Franklin's story is really inspiring, but it makes me really sad that she didn't get the credit that she deserved. I think we should all remember that when we work on a project, especially when we work together as we should, because science should be a collaboration where we work together, we need to make sure that everyone gets the credit that they need. We should never copy off of other people, and we should never take people's ideas and say that they're our own, because that's lying. Thank you so much for joining me on Storytime today. I'm really glad we got to learn about Rosalind Franklin and learn some lessons about how we can treat one another with kindness and work together in science, giving everyone credit for the things that we work on. Please don't forget to like and subscribe to the Lawrence at Home so you can get more updates on more cool story times like this and more other sciencey things that we do. I'm Teacher Vivian, and I'm signing off. Have a great day, everyone.